Please stand. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. My dear brothers and sisters, we have come rejoicing into the house of the Lord for this celebration. And now we stand with Lindsay and Raymond on the day they intend to form a home of their own. For them, this is a moment of unique importance. So let us support them with our affection, with our friendship, and with our prayer as their brothers and sisters. Let us listen attentively with them to the word that God speaks to us today. Then, with Holy Church, let us humbly pray to God the Father, through Christ our Lord, for this beautiful couple, his servants, that he lovingly accept them, bless them, and make them always one. In every celebration, we always sing the glory.
Thank you.
Let us pray. O God, who in creating the human race, willed that man and wife should be one, join, we pray, in a bond of inseparable love, these your servants, Lindsay and Raymond, who are to be united in the covenant of marriage, so that as you make their love fruitful, they may become, by your grace, witnesses to love itself. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Amen. You may be seated.
A reading from the book of Proverbs. When one finds a worthy wife, her value is far beyond pearls. Her husband, entrusting his heart to her, has an unfailing prize. She brings him good and not evil all the days of her life. She obtains wool and flax and makes cloth with skillful hands. She puts her hands to the distaff, and her fingers ply the spindle. She reaches out her hands to the poor and extends her arms to the needy. Charm is deceptive and beauty fleeting. The woman who fears the Lord is to be praised. Give her a reward of her labors, and let her works praise her at the city gates. The word of the Lord.
Call him. The Lord is near to all. A reading from the first letter of St. John. Beloved, let us love one another, because love is of God. Everyone who loves is begotten by God and knows God. Whoever is without love does not know God, for God is love. In this way, the love of God was revealed to us. God sent his only begotten Son into the world so that we might have life through him. In this love, not that we have loved God, but that he loved us and sent his Son as expiation for our sins. Beloved, if God so loved us, we also must love one another. No one has ever seen God, yet if we have one another, God remains in us, and his love is brought to perfection in us. The word of the Lord.
Please stand.
The Lord be with you.
With your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark. Jesus said, "From the beginning of creation, God made them male and female. For this reason, a man shall leave his father and mother and be joined to his wife, and the two shall become one flesh. So they are no longer two, but one flesh. Therefore, what God has joined together, no human being must ever separate." The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus. You may be seated. Good afternoon, everyone. Good afternoon. Hey, Mark, this is not a funeral. This is a wedding. We have to be happy. We have to rejoice when we get the chance. And we can even start in the church, not just at the reception, right? I have to tell you, this is a very unique couple. I've done many weddings, but this is the first where the groom is wearing a green velvet jacket. But you look good. And Lindsay, you look absolutely beautiful. Beautiful. Well, we gotta give credit where credit is due. Good job. Good job. I don't know about the rest, but yeah. Good job. Good job.
Thank you.
And the prayers, I know. But yeah, this is a beautiful couple. They get it. They understand what's important, what's not important. Being married in a church, they understand. Maybe it helps to remind us always, right? Because I think when we're young, teenager, we begin to doubt. Is there really a God who loves me so much? Like in the second reading, it's not that we love God, it's that God loved us. I mean, I know who I am, and you're telling me that he still loves me? So when we're teenagers, we kind of begin to doubt, you know? Unconditional, total love. And then all of a sudden, we meet someone who loves us and knows us and loves us. And that helps us to remember once again that there is someone who can love me just the way I am and will love me always. The words that Lindsay and Raymond will say to each other, they're not original. The last thing that Jesus ever said on earth is what Lindsay will say to Raymond, and Raymond will say to Lindsay, I will be with you till the end of time. I will always be with you till the end. And that's what they're going to say to each other. They're not here today because they fell in love in fifth grade. Can you imagine? Marrying your fifth grade companion in school? They've known each other since fifth grade. But they're not here because of that. They're not even here because they love each other. Yeah, you love each other. Yeah, okay. You can do whatever you want. So we love each other. Yeah, that's good. That's great. Beautiful. We want to live together. Do you have to go to a church to live together? Yes, but anyways. But technically speaking, no, you want to live together? Yeah. We want to have a family together. Oh, okay. Love each other, live together, have a family together. Okay, yeah, great. Is there anything higher than that? Anything even better than that? Like the best? They want the best. They want to go all the way. And what's all the way mean? Before Almighty God and before my family and all my friends, I want to make a promise to you that I will love you and honor you all the days of my life. That is the only reason why we are here. Because Raymond and Lindsay love each other so much that before God and before my parents and my siblings and all my friends, I want to make a promise to you and only to you that I will love you and honor you all the days of my life. If you can't think of anything more romantic and more beautiful, that's why we lit the candles. Why we have the music, because it's the words that they're going to say to each other that makes all the difference in the world. This is a beautiful couple because they love each other a lot. And here we are today, my dear brothers and sisters, to celebrate this moment and to remind ourselves, okay, if I've ever had those doubts in my mind, God truly love me this much? If he only knew. And the answer is, oh yeah. Because if God can love me and someone next to me holding my hand can love me, then I'm definitely ready to make that commitment to that person for the rest of my life. And you see what they're doing? You can't see what they're doing. They're holding hands, right? They're holding hands. Now, the only thing you have to be careful of, okay? This is the only thing I would say you have to be careful of. Don't take this for granted. Always hold each other's hands. Always give each other a hug. Always kiss each other. Always call each other the names that you give each other. Always. And don't wait for Valentine's Day. But do it all the time. Because this is something, this is the only moment in our life that we feel the closest to what it means to love someone. When it's me and only me. How God loves us. So congratulations. May God bless you, watch over you, protect you, guide you, defend you. And may the Lord keep you always close to his heart. Amen?
Amen.
And the moment has arrived. Ready? Let's go. Dearly beloved, you have come together in the house of the Lord so that in the presence of the church's minister and this community, your intention to enter marriage may be strengthened by the Lord with a sacred seal. Christ abundantly blesses your love. And through a special sacrament, he enriches and strengthens those he has already consecrated by holy baptism, that they may be faithful to each other forever and assume all the responsibilities of married life. And so in the presence of the church, I ask you to state your intentions. Raymond and Lindsay, have you come here freely and without reservation to give yourselves to each other in marriage?
Yes. Yes.
Will you love and honor each other as husband and wife for the rest of your lives?
Yes.
Are you prepared to accept children lovingly from God and bring them up according to the law of Christ and his church?
Yes.
Since it is your intention to enter into marriage, join your hands and declare your consent before Almighty God. I, Raymond.
I, Raymond.
Take you, Lindsay.
Take you, Lindsay.
To be my wife.
To be my wife.
I promise to be true to you.
I promise to be true to you.
In good times and in bad.
In good times and in bad.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
I will love you.
I will love you.
And honor you.
And honor you.
All the days of my life.
All the days of my life.
I, Lindsay.
I, Lindsay.
Take you, Raymond.
Take you, Raymond.
To be my husband.
To be my husband.
I promise to be true to you.
I promise to be true to you.
In good times and in bad.
In good times and in bad.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
I will love you.
I will love you.
And honor you.
And honor you.
All the days of my life.
All the days of my life.
May the Lord in his kindness strengthen your consent. The consent you have declared before the church and graciously bring to fulfillment his blessing within you. What God joins together, let no one ever separate. Amen. May the Lord bless these rings which you give to each other as a sign of your love and fidelity.
Lindsay, take this ring.
As a sign of my love and fidelity.
As a sign of my love and fidelity.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
And of the Son.
And of the Holy Spirit.
And of the Holy Spirit.
Raymond, take this ring.
Raymond, take this ring.
As a sign of my love and fidelity.
As a sign of my love and fidelity.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
And of the Son.
And of the Holy Spirit.
And of the Holy Spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, please rise. Lord Jesus, who are today present in our midst. As Lindsay and Raymond seal their union, accept our prayer and fill us with your Spirit.
For this bride and groom, and for their well-being as a family, let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For their relatives and friends, and for all who have assisted this couple, let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For young people preparing to enter marriage, and for all whom the Lord is calling to another state in life, let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For all families throughout the world, and for lasting peace among all people, let us pray to the Lord. For all members of our families who have passed from this world, and for all the departed, let us pray to the Lord. For the church, the holy people of God, and for unity among all Christians, let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord Jesus, who are present in our midst, as Lindsay and Raymond seal their union, accept our prayers and fill us always with the Holy Spirit. You will live and reign forever and ever. Amen. You may be seated. My brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept this sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church. Receive, we pray, O Lord, the offering made on the occasion of the sealing of the sacred bond of marriage. And just as your goodness is its origin, may your providence guide its course. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for you have forged the covenant of marriage as a sweet yoke of harmony, an unbreakable bond of peace, so that the chaste and fruitful love of holy matrimony may serve to increase your love throughout the world. By your providence and grace, O Lord, you accomplish this wonder for the rebirth of our world. And so through him, with all the angels and saints, we sing the hymn of your praise, as without end we acclaim. Be seated. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for him." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and, once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. As we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Edward, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Corpus Christi, custodium vitam eternam. Thank you. Let us pray. May God, the Eternal Father, keep you always of one heart in love for one another, that the peace of Christ may dwell always in you and abide in your home now and forever. Amen. May you be blessed in your children, have solace in your friends, and enjoy true peace with everyone you meet. Amen. May you be witnesses in the world to God's love, so that the afflicted and the needy who have known your kindness may one day receive you thankfully into the eternal dwelling of God. Amen. And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. It is my pleasure and my privilege to introduce to all of you Mr. and Mrs. Wilcox. You may kiss your beautiful bride.